So, I had to kind of change that on the fly for that session. Going overboard was not part of the plan.
I kind of figured.
You know, the events were going to be pretty minor. Now, how it was supposed to go down, or not even supposed to go down, I had to change these guys' motives too. They were just going to straight be slavers. And one night in week three, you guys were just going to wake up with two of them in each room. One each with a net and one each with a weapon.
So I saved us from being enslaved.
Well, not just you.
It more changed when the overboard thing happened. I'm like, okay, they were sympathetic then. I don't want to make them just pure callous. Because then why would they have saved the guy? I guess he would have been worth money alive, but not enough to stop the boat and endanger people's lives.
Yeah.
I don't know.
I bled into the ocean to make these people better.
Yeah. Let a shark go nom on me to make them better.
Well, it could have been that they know that the people would have, like, mutinied if they didn't rescue a person.
Even I was going to think, like, you know, if they're going to enslave us, then it's like, yeah, you go over there and you're, like,
there was an extra six guys originally, too.
I would have fucking taken them. When I was awake, I would have fucking taken them.
Also, so if they didn't help us, my plan originally was to grab a rope and just tie it to something and jump overboard.
Yeah, I wonder what would happen if I kept them callous and they just kept sailing on.
I literally, like, if I had woken up, I would have been threatening people, and then if not, would have been killing people.
But by that point, the ship would have been so far away.
Yeah, Baron would have been dead.
Maybe.
Yeah, we would have been talking probably at that point, if you at least...
I wouldn't have known that, though, so I would have been like,
nah,
you will go back. Woke up,
nah, they'd have to save the cargo. Gotta save the cargo.
That made things interesting. Yeah.
So Baron saved the day.
If one of us didn't witness it, they might have actually sailed on.
Baron awakened their guilty conscience.
Well, it just taught my guy to never leave his guy alone.
Never sleep. I wrote that down.
I don't actually never. No, that's not actually what happens. He just
said that. Always,
yeah, he said that as like a thing, but he doesn't mean he's actually going to do it.
I thought you were lawful. You're supposed to keep your promises.
My promise is to protect him, not.
My role is
to get sleep.
There you go.
My role is to not sleep. Not really.
Yeah.
Be a stern watcher over the front of the ship.
I just now sleep in the same room with my, like propped near him kind of thing to make sure that he's not being attacked or anything.
Falls out the ship window, still doesn't wake up. If there was a window, I'm sorry.
Wooden ships didn't have as many windows for that.
And unless they were cannon windows.
Yeah, that's usually, it was only
Which, like a pretty sure these rooms didn't have cannons in them.
Yeah, it's normal.
Yeah, I was actually wondering if the ship had cannons, but I didn't see any downstairs.
It had a harpoon up front, and it's not meant for fighting, it's meant for evading. And it's a small little vessel. It's 100 feet, it's not small. You know what I mean.
It's mostly just like a frigate or something, isn't it?
Yeah. It's meant for transporting cargo. And, I mean, their defense is guys with crossbows, and if a ship comes up aggressively, maybe shoot flaming bolts at the sails.
Also, like, if I don't forget, I guess next session I'll go back down into the hold to make sure I didn't miss anything.
For sure. I assumed you guys did that as well. And check out the captain's room.
Okay.
Yeah, we haven't been in the captain's room, meow.
We would have checked that out now that it's all done.
Yeah, that's why I kind of expedited all of that.
Okay.
It's 2 in the morning. The session was supposed to end around 1 o'clock at the latest.
Yeah,
our sessions never do that.
Yeah, that's fine.
But an extra combat had to happen.
Yeah, thanks, Baron.
Yeah, Baron. It worked out in the thanks end. For making the game interesting.
Yeah. It was for me. I finally got to use a breath attack.
Oh, yeah. Did everyone have a good session?
Oh, yeah.
Great. That was fun. I loved it.
I'm excited and also afraid of getting back to work and actually building this city and world.
I feel like this you should be afraid.
Yeah, you know, the one guy took 7 days to build a world. It's hard for me.
Yeah. Well, keep in mind, too, like, you only have to build pieces because we're not going to move through it that fast. Like, yeah. This was literally an event that was supposed to take.
That's why I did this.
Half the time.
If everything went as quickly as possible, it would have ended with you getting to the city and, like, meeting some people. That's it. Like, not much else.
But it never ends that way because me and Aaron both have terrible roles.
You just always assume everything's going to take longer. But you have to have a plan in case it goes short. And they're like,
everybody,
we're not going to investigate, but we're going to be super safe and bar our doors so no one gets in every night. And I'm like, okay, my party is super paranoid for no reason.
Yeah. No reason, knowing you.
I beg to differ. I have plenty of reason to be paranoid now.
Yeah. Just going to be dreaming of sharks for weeks.
I mean, to be fair, the odds of that were stupid low. It wasn't just one. It was the crit failure followed by, like, a crit failure, followed by a 2, followed by me rolling the max roll, a 94 out of 100 on the enemy table.
And they luckily rolled in that 20.
Yeah,
when we tried to freaking convince you to...
100 was a crack, wasn't it?
Yes. Which is kind of impressive, considering the whole plot of the game is that a Kraken was killed, and that's why people can actually safely travel to this eastern continent.
And now you killed one.
Yeah, I'm like, well, that kind of went out the window.
We would not be able to kill a Kraken.
Definitely not.
You could.
I highly doubt it.
Everybody gets consecutive crits infinitely.
Because I don't know how much life it has or how much AC, but I'm pretty sure it's like a boss monster.
I mean, it's possible.
Yeah, not very likely.
It's not likely at all, but it's definitely possible.
It's possible, but not probable.
I mean, if I could swim, maybe I could, like, if I had the breathing thing, then could swim kind of thing, maybe I could fight it on equal terms. No, but, like, I could fight it at that point, like, actually underwater, so if it pulls me underwater, yeah, I'm not dying.
Having the primary benefit to having a swim speed is you don't have disadvantage attacks.
Yeah, but it's also the underwater breathing that I get later on.
Yeah.
If I choose that, it's like, I could be underwater and be like, hey, you're coming after me, you're not going for the ship anymore. Ha 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 ha, like,
fight me. Speaking of which, no level up for this session, guys. It's just getting to the island. I know it's a major point, but functionally this was going to be the level 1 to level
2. Yeah, we'll just say we level 2 during
level 1 to level 2. Two people fucking died.
Two people nearly died.
They got not unconscious. That's not dead.
People can die in level 1 encounters.
Oh, yeah, people especially die in level 1.
I just realized, like, if that shark hit Baron, he would definitely be dead right now, because he failed one death save.
That shark missed 3 times consecutively, counting the first opportunity attack. And each of those attacks was 2d8 plus 4.
Charles is a walking miracle right now.
An average roll would have put Baron to like 2 HP.
Holy shit.
So, did I introduce enough chaos to make up for the absence of the wild sorcerer?
Yes.
Yeah,
you did.
Talk about wild magic.
So,
we'll have a job next week, hopefully.
So in the next session, I'll make sure to burn down the building we're in so I can add some fucking
chaos. Assuming next session is next week, because, you know, things
could happen. Yeah, let us know. Let us know.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Stay tuned to everybody in the D&D channel.
Keep an eye on the channel. All that stuff.
I should call it the background this time.
If you wouldn't mind just adding the role, Beauchard, if you're asking anybody for like times or whatever, you can just add the role. So okay, like cool. The D&D people just be like, hey, are you guys going to whatever this day, or I need this or something, then people can respond. So just helps flash it for people in case they don't see everything, because sometimes my thing doesn't pop up unless somebody adds me.
Oh yeah, you gotta have it as a notification.
Yeah, so most of the time it will.
I'm just posting to everybody.
Yeah, most of the time I'm checking it just in case it's something important.
Is there an at a certain group?
Yeah, so if you, that's the new role I made, which the new role is the D&D Vanguards. You just go like at D&D like this and say, hey.
What is like it that is up?
And I'll have to add blue to that.
Yes. Stop pinging me.
And Yatsu, cool. If he joins us, well, I'll have to add him to that, but we'll see.
Yeah.
I'm not sure he's going to do that.
Thanks, everybody, for playing.
No problem.
Thank you for doing the session.
Kick-ass DM.
Yeah.
Yes, it's fun.
I gotta be a little better at actually having numbers and stuff written down.
That's okay.
Yeah, it's fine.
But I think everything went about as good as we could hope. Except for the near deaths.
I mean, it did go as good as we could have hoped for the near death, because they didn't die.
The only way this could have gone better is if I got to push the captain overboard at the last, like, thrust.
That would have been funny. I like the creativity with it, so I kind of went with it, even though it's beyond the scope of shove.
That one would have been a grapple.
Close enough to the edge where you'd be pushing him into the banister. I'll give you a chance on it.
That one would have actually, for next time, that'd actually be a grapple and a shove on the next turn. If you're going to do something like that.
5 feet.
Right. If you're going to throw him over the thing, though, like, it would be a 5 foot. Yeah, you have to.
And then winning an athletics check to basically grapple money.
All right. Well, I'm gonna go, guys.
All right. See ya.
Later.
Later.
Sorry to keep you guys so late.
Yeah, it's fine.
Later.
Thank you again for the session.
Thank you.